It has already begun.
Why are we even here? You don't have any wounds or scratches. You didn't even get hurt from our fall earlier.
Mio, thank you so much. I'm so grateful to you. If not for you, something bad could have happened to Greta and the baby. Thank you for the money you gave Guta. I'll never forget this. Oh, are you a friend of Mio's? Well, come on, let's go. Let's go look at the baby. She's so cute. Come on. Hurry up, you two. Hurry. Mio, come over here. Look at this baby. It's Greta's. You see her? Look at her nose. My goodness, she's got Greta's nose. I know that nose anywhere.
What?
She's so cute,
I can't
right?
believe this.
Oh, hold on a second. I completely forgot. The reason I went downstairs is because I needed to buy some medicine. It's a good thing there's still some money left over from what you gave us. All right, I'll go.
Mother, don't.
What? I shouldn't buy the medicine?
No, Mother. I'll buy it instead. I'll do it.
Oh, no, I'll do it, Mio. Just watch over the baby, okay? Hey, Mia's friend, I'll leave you two to take care of things, okay? We need that medicine. I'll be back.
Your family has already spent my money.
Mio, you're here!
Hey, weren't you the kid that stole my money?
Guta, hold on!
This guy's pretty strong.
I'll pay you back, okay? How much is it?
10,000 bucks. This kid stole 10,000 bucks from me!
Guta, you stole 10,000 from him?
The doctor didn't want to take it at first. It wasn't enough. Mother just begged him to help Greta.
So what now? How will you guys pay me back?
I'll pay you, I promise. Just not right now.
What do you mean not now? When will you pay me then?
I don't have any money yet.
No! I'm a big boy now. I'll pay for the money I stole. It's not fair to you, Mio. I mean, you just joined our family and you just got dragged into our problems.
Hold on. You two aren't related?
We just adopted Mio. He has no one. He's alone now.
I swear I'll pay you back. I'm sorry for taking it. We just really needed the money right now.
Well, I'm sorry too, but I need that money as much as you do. That money is for my grandfather's surgery.
Listen, I'm not saying I'm going to turn back on my obligation. All I need is a little more time. If you want, you can give us your address so we'd know where to find you once we have the money.
No way. I'm going to get your address so I know where to go to collect my money, all right?
Collect money? Collect money for what? Jethro, I'd go crazy if it was Jake they caught.
Just calm down, Veruska.
Hold her!
Go of me!
Stop struggling already!
Where are you taking me? Let me go!
She has a flight to Brazil. It's a good thing the head of immigration is our ally.
Brazil? Do you know it's been 14 years since a werewolf has been able to leave? Or enter the country, for that matter. You're quite brave to try and escape. Where have you been hiding all this time? That you haven't heard about my great power?
you're wearing clothes. You want to take advantage of me, huh?
No, ma'am, I don't. Please don't shout.
A pervert!
Please keep your voice down. I'm not
you're a pervert.
Pervert!
Well, Veruska, do you know this werewolf?
I don't. This is the first time I've seen her. She's not a member of the LLU, so just let her go.
That's right. We don't know each other at all.
If I don't have any use for you, then I'll just kill you right now.
Yes, Veruska and I know each other. She's the Lord Sentinel's wife. My name's Denise and I'm a member of the LLU. We all live together at the camp.
In that case, then you know the new chosen one. You know what Malia looks like.
I'm really sorry for this. Come on, Kuto. Follow me. We need to talk.
Hey, I have some money here, but it's only 2,000. Just take it for now. As for the rest, I promise that we'll pay it back. I also want to apologize for what my son Kuto did. You know what? Why don't you give me your number so I can text you our home address? That way, if I fail to pay you, you can go to our house.
All right.
Listen, I'm sorry, okay? You got dragged into our family problems. I promise we'll give you back your money.
Look, Kuto, I know our family is poor, but we are not a family of thieves, got it? The only thing your father and I can teach you are the right values. You, Lisa, and Mio. The reason why we adopted you is because we truly believe that everyone has a right to be given a second chance in life. You have the right to experience how it is to have a complete family. So I'm warning you, Kuto, if you don't stop what you're doing, we will not consider you our real son anymore, you hear me? So stop it, all right?
I don't want that, Mother. Please don't kick me out of the house. I'm sorry for what I did.
Promise you won't do it again?
I won't do it again.
You promise?
Yes, I promise.
All right, come here. Come here.
You know, Mr. Berto, if I were rich, I wouldn't ask you to pay me back. But the problem is I also need that money. All right, then. I'll go ahead.
Listen. I'll give you everything your heart desires. If you'll give me everything my heart desires, I'll give you freedom. You can start a brand new life in Brazil. But to get that, all you have to do is describe Malia's face.
No, Denise, no. Don't believe in what he's saying. He's just putting one over you. Look at me. Do you know why I'm still alive? It's because I don't give him what he wants, so don't give in.
I will have no use for Veruska. If you are going to help me.
All right. I'll cooperate with you, Supremo. I'll describe to you what Malia looks like.
Weren't you just upstairs?
I was.
So? What else do you need? What do you want from me?
I'm going to help out so we can pay you off sooner. I don't want them to bear this alone.
Miss, where are you going?
I'll get off here. You have a jeep, right? I can join you when you go on your route. I'll be your barker.
How did you know I drive a jeep?
Kuta told me a while ago that you're a jeepney driver. Well, is there a job you can give me or what? This is for my family.
Hold on. Say ah.
What?
Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Open it! This is just a dental checkup before you can work in the auto shop.
Well, will you give me a job or not?
Are you a good person?
Of course.
This is a gentleman's agreement. My name's Tristan, by the way.
Mia.
Make her nose a little thinner, then make her eyes a bit rounder.
Are you sure about what you're doing?
I am, Supremo. Her nose is thinner. Make her eyes a bit rounder. That's what she looks like, Supremo.
Is this what Malia looks like?
Yes, Supremo. That's Malia's face. I've already described Malia for you. You're going to let me go now, right?
That's not really her. She doesn't know Malia at all!
No, don't believe what she said. I grew up with Malia and I know what she looks like. Thank you so much, Supremo.
Don't put her in here! You already know what happens to a werewolf after they're bitten by a vampire, right?
It's already past midnight, Tristan.
Oh, Grandpa.
You came back pretty late. You might be tiring yourself too much. You've done nothing else but take care of your family, you know?
Grandpa? Can your eyes wait a bit longer? I just need a little more time. Something unexpected happened earlier. I hope you understand.
While I can still see all your beautiful smiling faces, I can wait a little longer.
We can wait too.
Yes, that's right. We can wait.
You're still awake.
Of course, we can't just let you and your grandfather bond by yourselves. What about us? Isn't that right, Gabrielle?
I know I smell like morning breath, but I don't care anymore. I'm still going to embrace you.
Oh, Apple. Listen, no matter what kinds of problems may come our way, as long as we're all together, we'll be able to deal with it.
That's right.
Just remember, Tristan, what's important is for you to be careful, okay?
I will, Aunt.
Well, come on! Since we're all awake, let's have a big group hug!
Let's go to sleep.
Mio! Mother. Mio, Kuto wants to say something to you.
Listen, Mio. I'm really sorry for what I did.
Is that all you're gonna say?
And also, I promise that I'll never do it again. I won't steal anymore. I won't snatch, I won't play tricks, I won't pickpocket or con anyone. I won't take things that don't belong to me anymore.
You promise?
I promise, forever and ever.
That will do. Mother, I'm also going to do my part and help pay our debt to that guy.
All right, sure. Thank you, Mio.
I'll go ahead then.
Mio, you're leaving already? Don't you want my blessing? My blessing! Come here! There. That's how you get a blessing. Do you know why you do this? This is how young people like you pay respects to their elders. So from now on, every time you leave, always remember to ask for a blessing. Do you understand?
I do. Bye, Mother.
Bye, son. Take care.
Hello there, Mio! Mother Dory! I don't have knits anymore!
Where have you been, Lisa?
At the beauty parlor, Mother.
Parlor?
I don't have knits anymore!
You don't have knits anymore.
You know what, Mother? I'm sure she borrowed a wig again.
All right, then. Let me see if you really don't have any knits. Oh, you're right. You don't have any more knits. I don't see them at all. Okay, let's go, kids.
Can you make us some coffee? Hey, come here.
Bye, Aunt.
Tristan, here. You clean up the mess, okay? There you go.
Aunt, just let Porky do it. I'm waiting for my new assistant. I can't do this.
Assistant? You have a lot of money that you can afford to give salary? Amazing!
Come on, Aunt. I don't have that kind of money. Mm-hmm. However, think about it this way. If I'm earning money here at the auto shop, and I'm also earning money driving the Jeep.
Uh-huh.
Well, it's like there are two of me. There are two Tristans who can earn money. So that means...
That means I'll earn double the money.
That's right. Both of us will earn double the money, Aunt. We'll share the earnings.
Well, that's the same thing. Tristan.
Oh, Mio.
Doc! He's here! He's here? You're so confident about this guy, huh? Where is he?
Oh, let's see him.
He's right here. Wait,
oh,
that's it?
That's his newest.
That boy looks like he can be Porky's clone.
Him?
Just look at him.
Cute.
I didn't know he had friends.
He's actually
like that.
Handsome.
He seems all right.
You shouldn't have obeyed him, Denise. You shouldn't have given Malia's description. Now they have it.
By cooperating with them and giving them information about Malia, you recklessly put my son's life in danger!
Look, I don't care about what you say anymore. I just want to get out of here. I want to be with my family right now.
But I can't protect my son from in here, don't you understand? I can't protect him from the...
Are you sure about this, Tristan?
I mean,
just look at him. He really looks like Porky's clone.
Come on, don't exaggerate. Mio, this is Doc. He's our chief mechanic here at the shop.
He's so cute.
This is Porky, our assistant.
Mm-hmm.
That's my Aunt Betty. And this is my aunt...
Madame, you will refer to me as Madame Summer, all right? I am the proud owner of this auto shop.
Oh, no, he's mine.
Tristan, if this arrangement gives me double the usual problems, then you will receive more than a double punch from me. Understood?
Oh dear. Don't mind her too much, all right, Mio? What matters is that Tristan and the others will have another assistant. I'll go inside now, okay?
Thank you, Aunt.
Doc? Thanks for the...
You're welcome.
I just saw him yesterday.
Betty?
Hmm?
The mug. You might forget to return it. you're finished with it, right?
Thanks.
We only have two mugs left.
Bye. Okay.
Doc, let Porky hold it.
Hi, Tristan. Hi. I missed you, Tristan. We haven't seen you in a long time. But it's okay. It looks like you have a new assistant. You're so handsome, mister. Tell us what your name is.
Mio.
Are you going to work here in the auto shop? Do you want to work for me too? I'll pay you extra.
Shut up, he's mine.
Hey, stop that. You two, don't start fighting. Mio might not come back here anymore.
Do you have any experience?
That's right.
Do you have any
experience?
What they mean is working in an auto shop. If you have any experience working as a mechanic.
Mm.
Well, everything can be learned, am I right?
He has
In short,
point.
You're saying that you don't.
Oh, never mind that, Doc. We can teach him anyway. All right, then. I'll drive the Jeep now.
Okay.
Hey, Tristan. Thank you so much.
No problem, man. Do your best, okay? Doc, I'll leave him to you.
All right.
Bye.
Well, let's go. You'll start today.
This one's called a spark plug. Do you know why?
Why?
So there's a spark in the plug. You just clean it up like this. We can still recycle it.
Okay.
Oh, Rebecca! Your friend's already left. What are you still doing here?
Oh, come on, Doc. I'm just trying to be friendly with the new Boilet so he doesn't feel lonely.
Boilet?
Yeah, Boilet. Just look at him.
Doc, 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 Doc. I gotta tell you. I have my doubts about Neo.
What is it?
I also have my doubts about him. I mean, just think about it. The cars here might get damaged if we let him do the fix him. He doesn't know anything about being a mechanic.
Doc, that's not what I'm talking about. What I mean is it's like he's not a real man. I think he's a member of the Federation of, what's your name
it's
again?
It's Rebecca,
yeah,
remember.
Rebecca.
Hold on a second. Why do you even think about that?
The way he looked at Tristan earlier was different.
The way he looked? The way he looked at Tristan?
Come on, Doc, you know what I mean?
I don't believe Porky one bit. If he was gay like me, I would have smelled it right away.
and my little nose is telling me that Mio is a real man.
Hold on a second. What's wrong if Mio is a member of his federation?
Nothing, Doc. It's just that we're one family here. There shouldn't be any secrets. Just look at Rebecca. We've already accepted him
here. That's right, so...
Well, let's go and ask him then.
Wait. What's wrong with you? Why are you harassing the kid? It's his first day in the shop. He might feel harassed and leave us just like that.
Let's have a bet, Rebecca. I bet that Mio is gay.
You want to have a bet? Mm. I bet he's a real man.
Shh. Whether he's really gay or not, just wait for him to admit it. Don't meddle in his business, got it?
But he's a man.
He's gay.
He's a man.
He's gay.
He's a man.
Shh. He's a man.
Are you scared now? Thanks to the betrayal of your fellow werewolf, I can finally find Malia. And when that happens, I will give you the opportunity to be happy. Because I'll show you how I'll end Malia's entire existence.
You will not succeed, Supremo. That's not what the prophecy says.
Just watch as I succeed and prove your prophecy wrong.
Malia hasn't returned since the last time I was here. I know you're going to come here no matter what. I really hope that you're doing well. Malia, I hope you're able to find my letter, so you'd know where to find me. I really want to see you.
Hey guys, here are your passes.
Oh,
yes.
There we go.
Give me one.
Nice one, bro.
And guys, please take care of your access pass, please. I don't have plans of making new ones.
All right.
Wow, they look legit.
Yeah, they look great.
You're good at this.
Hey guys.
Oh,
hey,
Prof.
Hey there,
Prof.
Well, Prof, are you coming with us?
I designed some special weapons for you guys to use. Tristan?
Ooh, look at those. Whoa.
Check these out.
That one's based on the weapon your father left you.
Looking for something girly, Joey?
Of course.
This looks
Thank
so
you, Prof.
Cool.
What about you, Prof? What's your weapon?
So, if we could just use guns, why do we have to make our lives harder with these? That's much easier.
But Prof. T, aren't guns ineffective against vampires?
That's where you're mistaken. This is not an ordinary gun. And this is not an ordinary bullet.
Oh.
This is special. This gun right here is designed to undoubtedly kill a vampire.
A
vampires really did take our loved ones away from us. Then we'll fight them and stop them from taking any more lives.
Well, will you allow the vampires to do that again? No!
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 No! No, right?
No!
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 Will you let that happen again?
No!
No!
No,
no, right? Right?
Never!
Never!
Never.
Never again!
Never again!
But the Venus Hotel Group isn't ours, so we can't cause any trouble there because that's what's going to stop us from getting Luningning.
Beloved Supremo, you don't need to worry about that, because we ourselves will accomplish the mission. We will make sure that no one will know about our plan. We will be able to get Luningning Ramos.
All right, this is called a jack. This is what we mechanics use to jack a car. Okay? And this right here is called a vice grip. You use it to grip. Okay? Now this is a screwdriver. It is used...
to screw, right?
No. It is used to drive. I was joking, you're right. It's for screwing. You're getting the hang of it. This is what I want you to do. I want you to find me all the things we just taught you there at the back, okay? So go there and find me a jack, vice grip, and a screwdriver, okay?
Got it.
All right, pull it, there you go.
And in this competition, the representative of the Philippines is the young Miss Luningning.
Go on, look for those tools.
Miss Luningning Ramos, who hails from San Isidro, is the best player in the entire country.
That's Ningning.
It looks like you're going to lose your bet with Rebecca. Mio's eyes are glued to that girl on TV.
According to Miss Ramos's childhood best friend and current boyfriend, Mr. Nognog Sebastian, their townmates in San Isidro are giving the young lady their all-out support.
Nognog!
The Datu Asian Finals will be held at the Venus Hotel.
My best friends, it's really you. I'll go there to see you. I have to be there.
Why is he looking at the guy the same way?
Mio? Where are the tools we asked for?
Oh, right, just a second.
You keep watching TV.
Luningning Ramos is all over the news now. I'm certain she and Malia will meet. So don't waste this opportunity to capture her. We have sent you all a copy of a drawing of Malia. You no longer have an excuse not to find her. Do you understand me?
Treat my best player, right?
Yes, you should, sir.
Well, if you need anything, just text me. I'll pay for everything.
Sir, I'm not trying to be rude or anything, but, I'm the only one who can give my babe everything she needs. I bought these caps, you know?
Okay, I'll go ahead.
Oh, okay, Sir Mavic. Thank you. Thank you. Hey, what was that all about? You're jealous, aren't you? You're jealous of
him! Of course not! Not!
I'm not. Come here, sit down.
Come on,
just
babe.
Sit down. Nog.
Babe, I'm sorry, okay? You know, you shouldn't be stressed, and I'm stressing you
That's
out. You
right.
should be relaxed.
I love you big time, Nog!
I love you big time, babe. Big time. Big time.
Big time?
Tristan, are you ready?
I'm all set.
Moon chasers?
Let's go.
Everyone you will see inside could be in danger.
I didn't recognize you, Prof. T.
Protect them. Then leave.
All right, let's do this, guys.
Bye, Prof.
Miss? I'm looking for Liningning Ramos.
Is she part of the tournament, ma'am?
Yes, she's a player.
If you have an invitation for the event, you may go inside, ma'am.
I don't have an invitation, miss.
I'm so sorry, ma'am. Unfortunately, only invited guests are allowed inside the venue.
Miss, can you get me an invitation? Please, I just really need to see Ning Ning. She's my childhood friend, my best friend, big time.
I'm so sorry, ma'am, but I can't help you. The invitation is given by the organizer. If you don't have an invitation to the event, you really can't go inside the venue.
Babe, this is a big game, okay? But you can't let the pressure get to you.
Of course, I already know that, my Nog Nog. This fight is dedicated to you.
Babe?
Hmm?
Just be brave later, okay? Sadly, I won't be by your side while you're playing. But even if I'm far away or you don't see me at all, that doesn't mean I've abandoned you. Because no matter what, you'll never ever lose me. Okay?
But if you want, ma'am, I can call Miss Ramos in her room and tell her you're here, and if she confirms, then I can ask her to come down to the lobby to meet you.
That would be great! Please call her room for me. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Ready to rock?
Rock and roll,
rock
come
and roll.
On, let's go!
Okay, babe, let's go!
Woohoo!
You're gonna win this, babe! This game is yours!
Come on, hurry!
Ma'am, no one's answering the phone in the room. Miss Ramos is probably at the venue already.
I'm nervous. You better cheer for me, okay? Yeah, I
know. Tough opponent, right?
It's a hard opponent this time. Oh, hi! I'm a bit nervous, but I'll manage.
Ma'am, I'm sorry, but those are the rules. Without an invitation, I'm afraid I can't let you in the venue.
Sir, just let me in, please. I'm just going to see if my friend Liningning Ramos is inside. I'll be quick.
I'm sorry, I'm not allowed to let you in just like that. There's nothing I can do. Why don't you just call her on her cell phone so she can come meet you here at the entrance?
All right, thank you, sir.
Extras?
Oh my goodness, there she
Hey, back up! Don't let her try to...
It's Ning Ning!
Hey, you said just one! That's why!
So great!
Vampires.
Oh, all right.
All right, okay. One at a time, please. Give her some space. Back away.
Babe, come on.
Get your turn.
Okay, let's go. Believe
it. You're Supreme's followers.
Can I please have a picture with you?
Over here.
Have a picture with you. Back away now. Goodbye,
right.
Okay, back it up. Give her some room.
Sir, just one more photo.
Thank you.
They're still looking for me.